Oh, man.
This is raw Argent energy.
Raw Argent energy. Cyber Knights. I am out of explosives. I'm gonna see. Ah! I feel like I hit the right button. I did not. Yeah, I thought I freaking hit C, the chainsaw button. Maybe I get another chance to break this open. Here we go. Gotta get that floppy. Oh. All right, so I need to... I gotta get rid of you things here. Get rid of that shield guy, otherwise he's just gonna throw those things out. Where are you? Okay, now I see. Tried his best. All right, so I've got one. I want to chainsaw this guy, don't I? Doing better with the ammo. Whoa, so weird. All right, so I need to get up. There's a bunch of secrets here. So that's where I need to go. Something over here. A wall. Just notice there's still body parts falling down. Alrighty. How does one get over there? Maybe there's a way around once you get up this side, maybe? Alright, Fuel of the Eternal Flame Part 2. Alright, let me take another quick break here, stretch my legs, and be back, and we'll keep on going. About Fuel of the Eternal Flame. Maker's need for essence is prime. Without it, they must suffer a monstrous fate of transfiguration and see their wisdom and faculties slither from their twisted forms. By the bidding of the con maker herself, the Order of Deeg has devised a method to improve and accelerate the production of the Hell Aura. What once took eons for the savage beast to attain can now be accomplished in a short order by Argentia intellect, and with greater efficiency and consistency. constructed the Soul Spire as vast halls erected in the savage lands by our slaves under the direction of the Order. Even though we raised a monument on their ground, the Demonkind does not harry us during assembly of the Soul Spires. The Conmaker herself bartered a deal with the Dark Lord that rules over the Shadow Walkers. A bargain was struck. The demons would be given fresh worlds and souls to consume, bolstering their forces and expanding the corrupt domain of Hell, and the Makers would be granted access to the Flow of Argent. The process inside the Soul Spires is thus. Captives are tortured until no semblance of humanity remains with them. Bereft of hope, the mortal soul is vulnerable and can be easily extracted. This we achieve with a machine from the enlightened mind of the Conmaker herself, the Evulsor. Sounds painful. Once the Evulsor has done its deed, the soul has been extracted, the victim's body is ejected into the wasteland. As before, our cunning meddling comes demon over time. So basically, they just industrialize the whole process, you know? Mass produced. The assembly line. Flesh and metal. Maybe that is access to these things. Crazy. So, like, there's no other way to avoid them. I just gotta be quick, don't I? There we go, Tyrant found. So there is a grab here. Alright, so we need to go up when there's an extra life somewhere tucked up there along with the map. Oh, so many things and so many ways for me to kill myself. Is not quite what I'd hoped for. Now we're back here. So the one up is up to the top. Alright, so we go here and then here. Oh, ouch. There's much pain and suffering had by all. Let's go for that. As many ups as I can get. Boom, boom. Well, I missed time that long. That would go a little bit faster. So there's nothing. Like, all that hurts just from touching it.
No.
That sucks.
This facility was built in secret. The Night Sentinels never knew of its existence. Built by Sentinel slaves, for a Maker can never set foot in Hell, nor demon in Erdak. Argent Anur served a grave purpose to the Makers.
Alright, let me read the next thing here, part 3. We gather the volatile aura stored in vast reservoirs. There it is coalesces with wraith energy and subjected to the infernal fires of hell itself. In the heat of the primal fire, the essence is loosed and captured for our gain. The final stage of the process is divided, is the dividend of the gains. Vast quantities of essence are fed directly to Argent Anur to power our machine and drive our engine. The rest is reserved for the Khan Maker. Though she may never set foot in the Dark Realm, she has devised means to teleport essence to the Unholy Land. To the Holy Land. That which she calls Erdak, the domain of the angels. Her use of the essence is unchallenged, for it was she and her court that gave us design to capture the essence, and her payment is just. Looks like the machine, the divinity machine. All right, we got 4. We got another upgrade. Solid. What do I hope to see there? Get that shot. Man, the way they lob those big toxic blobs up there. Don't like them. Cybermen keep us. Not cool. I can't get over there, can I?
Get out, you stupid shield!
I'm gonna find that guy. I think I'll have to go. Hey. About you. Never just got that thing, did I? So we gotta make our way all the way up, huh? So I can't fall that far. I see. What is that? Well, that was not on one until I passed through it. Okay. Yeah. did not think there was still a mancubus up there. So you can fall through there. All right, all right. Don't win the battle with 5 health. Pinky down. Now to this mancubus. The mancubus. Not a boy cubus, but a mancubus. Oh, there's two of you up here. Quite what I had in mind. Sure that. Alright, let's get the rest of the stuff. Zombie. Got the vertical leap on that zombie. You see that? I'm impressed. Guess we just go. Okay. Don't think we're gonna break him, right? Just to piss off the maker. Warm. So we got some annoying eyeballs. Annoying eyeballs activate the lasers, if you're not gonna be there.